Did I ever tell you the one, why did the furnace get kicked out of school? Because it was caught smoking in the bathroom. All right. Hey, Dad, good morning.
How are you?
Today, we're getting into more air conditioner related questions. They're coming up a lot on our YouTube channel. We'll just go ahead and jump right in. First question says, my HVAC unit is running, and outside when I put my hand above the unit, it's not warm air, it's cool air. There's not very cool air blowing inside the house, though. What could this be?
Let me just check your knowledge. What would that be if you put your hand over the air conditioner? The fan's running, but it's not warm. What does that mean, Andrea?
Okay, that air should be warm because it's taking the hot air from inside the house and pushing it outside. So
that's right.
If it's not warm air, then you're not getting the hot air from the house out.
That's right. So... and what does that is the compressor. So what's happening here is, one, you are verifying that you've got a good call from inside, so there's nothing wrong with your thermostat, things like that. It's telling the unit outside to run, which part of it is, that fan is running. However, the compressor, which is deep inside the outdoor unit, is not running. Now, it's not running for, could be a host of reasons, but you're asking what could be the problem, so let's just think about those. One could be something as simple as a burned wire off of a compressor terminal or off of the contactor itself. You could have a failed capacitor or some other starting device that is hooked to the compressor and it's not running, or it's not allowing it to run. It could be a stretch that a pressure switch has it off, but typically that's going to turn off the fan as well. So it's going to be more electrical related to the compressor. So it's a burned or broken wire or a bad terminal on the starting switch, the contactor, or any combination of those. Could be a failed capacitor and a burned wire also, you know, so.
Okay.
But it's electrical to the compressors where you're having a problem.
All right, second air conditioner question. This was a comment to a video that we made about like different reasons why your unit might ice up. And with that video, our main piece of advice is that if you find ice on your system, turn it off, let it melt, and right, then we can come back and address it. This person is saying, I let my system defrost overnight and the ice is gone. I also changed the filter. I'm now trying to run the fan, but all I'm getting is a loud humming noise coming from the unit and no airflow. Does that mean I damaged something?
No, you've not damaged anything. And just know, we'll kind of reiterate, you should never have ice on your air conditioner, anywhere on your air conditioner. So if you ever do see that, even before you call a service technician, turn it off. Just turn everything off. But there are several things that can cause a unit to ice up. But the one that relates the most here, because we're talking about a fan motor inside that's only humming, is airflow. Poor airflow across the indoor coil will cause the unit to ice up. So a really dirty filter or a really dirty blower wheel or some combination of those. But other is a motor failure, and it kind of sounds... with it just humming, it's kind of telling me that they probably have a motor that has failed. Could also be, like the last question, some electrical component tied to that motor. But when I hear it actually humming, it's telling me that we could have more of a failure involved. But that's where your problem is going to lie, is indoors, your indoor blower motor is not running. So we're not moving air across that coil inside.
Okay, next question. My AC turns on, but it's not blowing strong enough.
Okay, not blowing strong enough. Well, we could check some rather obvious things. Let's make sure dampers are open, register dampers are open. It's a change of season, and you may not have thought about, you know, changing dampers, opening things up, that sort of thing. So first check that. Season maintenance also related are dirty filters or plugged up filters, or some combination of those things, you know, a dirty blower wheel, dirt, restricting airflow inside is what we're most concerned about. So make sure dampers are all open, make sure you have a clean filter, and we'll go from there.
We made a video on why your furnace might be making a high-pitched whistle sound. This viewer is saying their high-pitched squeal is in the lines. Their motor is fine, but why are the lines making a high-pitched squeal?
In those lines, that's good information there. Now, in the lines, I'd challenge the homeowner to check, when is it making that noise? And I would be most suspect that it's doing it at the end of a call for cooling. So, you know, the system has been on, it's been blowing air, the unit outside's been running, it's been running in a very stable way, and now when we shut things off, it abruptly shuts off the compressor, it abruptly shuts off the blowers inside, so things kind of go quiet, so you tend to kind of hear things. But at that point in time, on many systems, the equalization of the refrigerant pressure that goes through those lines, through the indoor coil, it can take just a moment or two, a couple of minutes to equalize the pressure. And you can kind of hear them kind of making kind of a squealing, gurgling kind of sound, you know, it only takes a couple of minutes for it to do it. But I would be suspect of it doing it at the end of a cooling cycle. And if that is the case, it really, sometimes we just have to find a way to isolate that. You know, is the refrigerant line touching something or in an exposed area? But it's not hurting anything. It doesn't hurt a thing. Sometimes it's just a result of the refrigerant charge versus the length of the lines and all those kinds of things, you know.
These people know us too well. This question says, ask your dad why every year when we first run the heater, it smells like burning dirt or something like that for the first day, and then it clears up. Thank you.
Well, yes, that's typically the first mark of fall. Winter is here when you smell that. And what that is all summer, your system has been circulating air through your home, and dust has accumulated on the heat exchanger if you have a gas furnace, or it's accumulated on the heating coils if you have an electric furnace. But either way, the first time you go to fire it up, that surface gets very hot. And in the case of the electric furnace, it's like a toaster. You know, when you look inside a toaster, you see them glowing red hot. Well, that's what your electric furnace does. Your gas furnace fires and your heat exchanger gets hot, and we're burning the dust off of that heat exchanger. Really just does it once. It's really the first cycle will take care of it. Burns it off, and then you never notice it again after that. But that's what it is. It's burning away all the summer dust off of your heat exchanger.
Did I ever tell you the one, why did the furnace get kicked out of school? Because it was caught smoking in the bathroom. I will add to that, I was following our technician Jordan along, and he was doing a maintenance visit for a new furnace that hadn't been turned on yet. And he explained to the homeowner that with the new furnace, it might be a really kind of weird smell and possibly even set off some kind of alarms in your house the first time you fire it up, because when they package up those furnaces, the new ones, they coat the heat exchanger in some kind of oils or whatever. And so that's what could be causing that too. But that should just be like when you first fire up a brand new one.
They put an oil film on them, you know, to keep them from rusting, and because they, you know, it could be months before the furnace is ever installed, that sort of thing. But it's not as bad as it used to be. Yeah, there'd be times we would fill a house with blue smoke. You know, that's how bad they got it. So
seems a little toxic, but yeah. Okay.
Actually, there's nothing wrong. This is absolutely normal. We filled your house with blue smoke, you know, but everything's fine.
No worries.
The smoke detectors will turn off.
Hey, how did that that job that you were talking about last week, the technicians at 1 hour were taking a house that had two systems and bringing it down to one, but with zoning. So how did that go?
Yeah. Well, it went extremely well. And the homeowner is very excited about the extra floor space we gave him. You know, these two furnaces were back to back. He had two furnaces back to back to each other. And he just figured they were going to get turned the same way they were. And we said, actually, we could do it this way and move everything. It basically was the equivalent of clearing off 3 feet of floor space, you know, in his basement rec room thing. So he was excited about that.
Nice. So Evan did a good job with the crew.
Evan did a good job. Yeah, it was tricky, tight in a few places, but it all worked out really well and looked nice.
All right. Well, thanks so much, Dad. And if anybody else has any questions HVAC related, leave them below and we will take a look at them for next week's show.
We'll try and help them. The homeowner and I have found that we have a lot in common. We both like orange cars. He went to an auto show, and he showed me the pictures he took, and he only took pictures of the orange cars. And so I don't know. I've got, an orange car.
Dad, don't be saying that this guy's weird and you're not about it, because you have your orange Harley and the Strider that you got for your grandkids to ride.
Orange.
Happens to be the exact same color, so
I want the kids to know it's cool. No, I'm not saying that's strange at all.
Actually, does mom and his wife like have a lot to talk about too?
Yeah, maybe we carry the conversation there. So.